Let me talk about vanity for a second.
Okay.
So I went to go get my hole widened in my throat the other day.
So weird.
You might want to explain that.
Going to. Okay. So I have sleep apnea, and this place approached me saying, we can help with your sleep apnea. I have to sleep with this breathing machine, a CPAP machine, every night. I've slept with it for 10 years, maybe longer. And it kind of sucks. I actually like the machine now. I'm used to it. But it does suck when you have to travel. It does suck if I have to go camping with my son, who's a Boy Scout, an Eagle Scout. You know, it does. There is some times where it really sucks. So it would be nice to be able to just fall asleep on the sofa and take a nap. It would be nice to be able to go visit my sister and crash anywhere, you know, sleep anywhere. But I can't. So this place approached me. They said, look, what we do, we have this laser that we laser your throat. You open up your mouth, and we open up the hole in your mouth. And when she showed me my throat, it turns out I have like a hole like the size of a penny. Mm-hmm. Whereas you guys, we looked at each other's holes. Your holes are like the size of a tangerine. Like I have a small hole. Mm-hmm. A very small hole.
It's tiny.
Yeah, so they've been widening it. So the other day, they were lasering the hole in my throat and making it wider. And they have all these machines there. And now there's another place I go to that does like all the Botox and all that stuff. Kyle and I go there. MD Skin Clinic. Dr. Golly. He's amazing, right? So they do all the stuff for my face. Everything. And other things, too. And they start telling me at the whole place, they look at these, they start talking about what their machine does, and they say that, and you know, it gets rid of these freckles and aging spots. I'm like, you can get rid of that? And then they go, yeah, look, they look at my arms, they go, oh, we can get rid of all that. Now, not once have I ever thought that I had freckles that were bad or that anything was wrong with anything in my arms. But they brought it up one time, and I could not stop thinking about the freckles on my arms.
They got in your head.
They got in my arms. So I reached out to MD Skin Clinic, and I was at this party. Kyle was with me at this party, and I said, what's up with these freckles on my arms? They go, oh, we can get rid of those. I go, sign me up. So 2 days ago, I went and got my hole widened. Yesterday, they went to remove my freckles. And I never asked any questions. I just said, let's go. So I went in yesterday. Oh, my God. It hurt.
What? I had that done. It didn't hurt.
It hurt. Well, you were a woman. You've had babies.
Yeah. It did not hurt.
It hurt me.
Month
it hurt me. Look at my arm. Then
let me
like,
see.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, it's like that for a couple of days.
You should see the bags back here.
But like, what's wrong with the freckles? Like, what's so bad?
They're just
about
like
them?
Not attractive.
Thank you, Kyle.
Really?
They
like,
never
I don't
bothered
think
me.
Anything wrong with them?
Because you don't have them.
Yeah.
But you never.
That's what people say
you
when
never
they don't
thought
have
about
freckles.
It.
Like, Delaney has so freckles, cute. And I think they're the cutest thing ever.
That's what people who say don't have them.
Do you like your freckles?
I never once thought twice about freckles until
yeah,
they told
exactly.
When the doctor said, we can get those removed. It was like when I used to have a big gap in my teeth, right? Mm-hmm. I had a huge gap. And you know, I was like 20 years old or something. I was looking at the back of the magazines for coupons to get my teeth cleaned to go to the dentist. I didn't have any money. It was like, get your teeth cleaned for $20. So I went to the dentist. And when the dentist was cleaning my teeth, he says, If you're ever disgusted with your smile, he says, jeez. He goes, we can fix this gap.
Oh, that's not a good sell.
And I was like, oh my God.
Harsh.
I was like, and I go, what do you mean? And he goes, look, and he does this thing. He takes like some kind of plaster and he fills in my gap with this plaster. He goes, look, and he fills in my gap. And I was like, oh wow. He goes, these are fallout in a couple of days. I was like, okay. So I went to go show my mom and show everybody that they filled in my gap. And it left such an impact that I think it was that night is the day I met my wife. So she doesn't know me without my gap. And I was so insecure now because he said disgusted with your smile that I eventually got veneers before we got married. So my wife Blake has never seen me with a gap in my teeth. Right. And I know she wouldn't care.
Right.
But anyway, so that's how affected I am when somebody of a position of power says something to me. Right. Oh, my God, your freckles. We can get those removed. What? Take them off. I remember one time the lady goes, hey, we want to advertise with you. Your hair is thinning. Would you like to get a hair transplant? I'm like, hair transplant? My hair is fine. Cut to 2 months later, I get a hair transplant. So, right?
Well, it's like, you know, I mean, like, you may not be critical of someone else's freckles, Suzette, right. But it's like when that person, like me, when I would look in the mirror, I would be like, oh my God, I hate these freckles. So it's like, just because you're not critical of it or other people may think they are cute or whatever, it's like, you know how it is when there's something on you that you don't like and you can take care of it, so you do.
But it wasn't something that was bothering him.
Not
it wasn't something
until,
that you were looking at until they called it out. And it's like,
until they
if they called it out because they work there,
Well, it's like the dentist. When the dentist said, if you're ever disgusted with your smile, not once had my gap ever bothered me in my entire life. Right. So
the people that were working there want you to get the procedure done.
Exactly.
Obviously.
And I'm telling you that it works. It gets in my head. I have a history of it getting in my head. So yesterday they zapped. So I have all these scabs on my arms. So my arms were burning when it was over. Right. I mean, burning. And they were even like, wow, your arms are really red. And I was like, and they also did the back of my neck. Right. So they give me this cream to put. And they said they were going to give you a little sample of cream. Put this cream on your arms when you're done. I'm like, all right. And my arms got so red, they actually handed me this giant tube. Like, first, they would give me a little thing. And they give me this giant, like full on Crest toothpaste of this numbing cream or something on my arms. So when I took it, I went home and I put it on and it was burning even more, right? And then they text me later, are you okay? I'm like, yeah, I think I'm fine. So everything was fine. Then this morning, I forget. And I jump in the hot tub like I do every morning.
No.
Like, so I get in the hot tub. Every morning I get in the hot tub, then I get in the cold plunge. And when I get in the hot tub, so it's like 3:15 and when I get in the hot tub, I just get in. I'm like, oh, yeah, it's all right.